Good morning, sisters. Today is Friday. We will have a quick review together so we can remember what we studied together during this week. The title of this lesson is The Call to Absolute Commitment, and today we will have the review questions. Question number one. How did the disciples react when called to work for the master? They quickly followed Jesus. They didn't ask how they were going to provide for their family, how they were going to survive. No, they left their nets and their boats and followed Jesus. And how does God provide for His workers today? He will provide the same way He provided for His disciples. For all that follow Jesus, they will lack nothing. God will supply all the needs of those who follow Christ in the path of self-denial and sacrifice. He will always provide for those that are engaged in the work of saving souls. Next question. What can we do each day in order to prepare ourselves to be witnesses for God? The preparation needs to be made day by day in treasuring up in our hearts the precious truths of God's Word, in feeding upon the teaching of Christ, and through prayer, strengthening our faith. So the preparation needs to be done today by studying the Word of God and through prayer. How will He assist us in our time of need? So now is the time for us to be preparing by studying the Word of God through prayer, and in the time of need, the Holy Spirit will bring to our minds all that we have learned, all that we have in our hearts and in our minds. He will bring us the words that we have to speak. We don't need to prepare a speech for that time. But the Holy Spirit will bring all these words to our lips, all the words that we need to speak in the proper time. As Jesus was trying to prepare the disciples for the scenes of His suffering, what was going on among them? They were discussing among themselves who should be the greatest in the kingdom of God, who should be the first. They were having this spirit of rivalry, competition. Each one of them wanted to be the greatest, but they were not. They were doing this discussion because they did not understand what was the nature of Christ's kingdom. The nature of Christ's kingdom is humbleness and humility. Question number four. Before Jesus asked the disciples to leave their occupations, what assurance did He give them? God gave them the assurance that He would supply all their needs. Before asking them to leave their nets and fishing boats, Jesus had given them the assurance that God would supply their needs. He who is rich unto all that call upon Him has said, Give, and it shall be given unto you. Good measure, pressed down and shaken together and running over. What can we learn from this? That God also, everyone that is going to make a sacrifice in His ministry, will be recompensed according to the exceeding riches of His grace. And God will provide for everyone as He has done in the past. God does not promise us ease, honor, or wealth in His service, but He assures us that all needed blessings will be ours. In this earth, with persecutions, with trials, but in the world to come, life everlasting. And the last question, what should be the criteria for us when deciding which career to follow or in what activity to engage? The criteria is that we should always seek first the kingdom of God, to live for Jesus. Because He died for us, we should also live for Him. All that we will do, we need to first see if we are going to please God. Seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. We are to engage in no business, follow no pursuit, seek no pleasure that would hinder the outworking of His righteousness in our character and life. So when we submerge ourselves into Christ, true love springs forth spontaneously, and then we will have a transformation of the whole heart, soul, and character, which is dead to self and alive unto God. May the Lord help us that we continue each day studying and growing in grace, and that we always live for the kingdom of God. It was a pleasure to spend this week studying with you. May the Lord bless you, have you a blessed Sabbath, and also that you continue participating in this pre-spiritual journey, and I'm sure it's going to be a blessing for each one. And the next week we will have another sister that will be sharing the lesson with you. God bless you, and we will see you next time. Bye.